Scorpio, this is your 2012 special forecast brought to you by InsightfulAstrology.com. Scorpio, in 2012, it is your year for personal definition, and I will explain more about that in just a moment. But first, let's talk about love and relationships. What we have when we begin 2012 is expansion everywhere, and that is continuing from late 2011. That's all thanks to Jupiter, the planet of expansion and abundance, now touring your seventh house of partnership, where it remains until June 11th. With Jupiter in this part of your chart, all partnership matters are exploding, and there's a lot happening for you. You're having opportunities in business partnerships. You're having opportunities in personal relationships. Some of you might find that your marriage or partnership is better than ever. And if things have not been so great, Jupiter just expands whatever's already there. So the job of Jupiter is not to gloss over the trouble, it's to bring it out and make you aware of it. But in general, Jupiter is a buffer, and usually you are able to resolve things in a very fortunate way. In addition to this, we have Neptune, the planet of inspiration and spirituality and unconditional love, entering your fifth house of romance on February 3rd. Neptune remains here for many, many years, and you are now about to be enchanted in matters of the heart. If you're single, this could be a time of spellbinding love, and you could meet a soulmate. If you're attached and you're in a good relationship, suddenly you're going to feel that fairy tale romance coming back between you and your love. In terms of work and career, there isn't so much happening for you this year that's just awe-inspiring, but if you own your own business, I do want to caution you about the Mars retrograde cycle that's happening from January 23rd until April 13th. Mars will be retrograde in your 11th house. And the 11th house is concerned with friends and groups. So yes, on some level, there might be some issues to work out with a group or with a pal. But as far as business is concerned, if you are the owner of your own company in business for yourself, the 11th house rules money that you earn from that business. And with Mars retrograde in the 11th house during those early months of 2012, you might be rehashing something with finances from your own business. It could be a frustrating time. It is a time when you are supposed to be planning for more power in your earning capacity for business. So if there is a setback, if there is a bit of loss or frustration, just know that after April 13th and through July 3rd, you'll be in a very strong position. When it comes to money, there's a lot going on, so much. Jupiter, the planet of expansion and abundance, is going to enter your eighth house of joint finances after June 11th. And with this energy, there comes a lot of potential to get money from sources beside your own income. It's a great time for inheritance matters, dividend payoffs, royalties, settlements, all of that. And if you're married, your spouse's income might increase. But first, you have to get through the Venus retrograde cycle, because Venus rules money, and it'll be retrograde in your eighth house from May 15th until June 27th. And this is a time when you will also be revisiting some intimacy issues, if there is any to visit in a personal relationship. But again, we're focusing on money here because the eighth house and Venus, money, money, money. So there's gonna be something that you're going back to. Maybe you're renegotiating a big business deal. Maybe you are refinancing your house or taking out a line of credit. This could have to do with all of that. There is a solar eclipse on May 20th. So in between that Venus retrograde cycle, you're going to have the solar eclipse of new opportunities with eighth house money to tend to. Then on June 4th, there's a lunar eclipse in your second house of earned income. That lunar eclipse could bring an ending to a source of income, or it could just bring matters about personal finances to a very big illumination. There's a final eclipse on November 28th in your eighth house, bringing to light the joint financial matters that will be at hand. Personal definition, that's your theme for 2012. We begin this whole personal definition of yours when you consider that Saturn, the planet of structure, will enter your sign after October 5th. And a solar eclipse on November 13th will also fall in your sign. So towards the end of 2012, Scorpio, you are serious about clarifying your identity.